Hey guys, how are you all? My name is Harshit Devedi, friends, and I welcome you back to my video. So in this video, friends, I will be discussing with you Lala Lajpat Rai's biography, his life, his role in Indian freedom struggle, friends, his ideology, his early life, his education, his parents, family, his role in freedom struggle. Everything in detail will be discussed by me, friends. So this video is brought by me. If you want to follow me, friends, my Instagram profile link is given in the description box below. Also, friends, if you want to watch the Hindi version of that video, the link of the Hindi version of the video is also given in the description box below. Okay. See, this is the commemorative stamp of Lala Lajpat Rai issued by the India Post. So let's start with it. Friends, Lala Lajpat Rai was born on 28th January 1865 in Dudhi Ke Place in Punjab. The name of his father was Munshi Radha Krishna Azad. And the name of his mother was Gulab Devi. Now, Gulab Devi was a very spiritual and religious woman. And this was because of his education that Lala Lajpat Rai transformed himself into a very characterful man. Okay, he had quite diverse views. And he had a very mature personality. So, all of this can be attributed to the upbringing of his mother, friends. Also, the name of wife of Mr. Lala Lajpat Rai was Radha Devi. He was educated from Government College in Lahore. He did law from there. He was associated with Indian National Congress and Arya Samaj. And he had written a lot of books. For example, he wrote The Story of My Deportation. He wrote it in 1908. Then Arya Samaj in 1915. He also went to United States of America, friends. He lived there from 1917 to 1920. So he wrote The United States of America, A Hindu's Impression in 1916. He wrote Young India in 1916, wrote England's Debt to India, India 1917. He died on 17th of November 1928, friends, and his, unfortunately, was not a natural death because while protesting in Lahore against the arrival of Simon Commission in India, because of the brutal lathi charge by the police, which was specifically directed at Lala Lajpat Rai, took away his life due to his injuries. So we'll talk about all these things later in the video, friends. So he was a very prominent nationalist leader, friends. And he was the name of an informal grouping. He was a part of an informal grouping named as Lal Bal Pal. We all have heard about this tribe of friends, Lal Bal Pal. Lal means Lal Lajpat Rai. Bal means Bal Gangadhar Tilak. And Pal means Bipin Chandra Pal. Now this was a very important tribe of the Indian independence movement, friends. We will talk about them later. Also, the name, one famous name of Lal Lajpat Rai was Punjab Kesari. He was also known as the Lion of Punjab. Okay, now moving forward, friends. He was also credited with the founding of Punjab National Bank. And what happened at that point of time, friends, that there were many Christian missionaries, you know, those children who were orphans. Now, these orphan children were being provided care by the Christian missionaries, and those Christian missionaries used to convert those children to Christianity. So, this was not liked by Lala Lajpat Rai. So, he founded the Hindu Orphan Relief Movement to protect these children from being converted to Christianity in 1897. And obviously, the role of Simon Commission will be discussed later, friends. So, born on 28th of January to Munshi Radha Krishna Azad, his father was actually a scholar of Persian and Urdu, and he used to work as a teacher, friends. His mother, I already talked about, he was a very religious lady. He taught, you know, he imbibed very high cultural values in Lala Lajpat Rai. Now, the elementary education of Lala Lajpat Rai was done in Rewari Government Higher Secondary School. In this school, his father was posted as a teacher, so he was also living there. Lala Lajpat Rai went to study law in Government College at Lahore in 1880, friends. He was there in Government College. He studied the law there. And this was at this time of time, he came in touch with many prominent revolutionaries of Indian freedom struggle. So friends, now the leaders which he met during studying law in Government College Lahore, they were Lala Hans Raj, Pandit Guru Dutt, and there were many more people, friends. And the point is, friends, that when he completed his law education from government school in Lahore, he then moved to a place named Hisar in Haryana. And there he started his actual legal practice. Now, this actually happens in the life of every lawyer, friends. After you doing law, you attach yourself with a lawyer or advocate in any court and then work under him understanding how this thing works, how he takes up the cases, you assist him, you get a small pension. So he started practicing his law in Hisar fronts. But the point is that he was a nationalist at heart, and he always wanted to serve his country, and he was never comfortable with the fact that there is foreign rule inside his country. Someone else has came from outside India and they are ruling him. Then in 1884, his father was transferred to a priest in Haryana named Rohtak. Lala Lajpat Rai also went there with his father. Lala Lajpat Rai was married to Radha Devi ji in 1877, friends. Now, what happened that they went to Hisar in 1886. You know, friends, that in 1885, Indian National Congress was formed. And Lala Lajpat Rai attended the 1889 and 1888 session of the Indian National Congress as a delegate. Okay. At that point of time, he attended those functions as a delegate of those functions, friends. Also, after that, he moved to Lahore to practice law in the High Court of Lahore in 1892. Now, one thing, friends. This time, 1880, 1890. So, at this point of time, revolutionary nationalism was not very much existence. Reason being, the initial Indian National Congress was dominated by moderate leaders. And these moderate leaders always preferred constitutional methods of struggle, like prayer, protest, petition. Okay. So, they never supported the revolutionary ideas. Okay. But still, Lala Lajpat Rai was, in his innate nature, very revolutionary in attitude. Why he was so? Because he was very inspired with the ideas of patriotism and nationalism. Now, from where did he got these ideas, friends? Actually, Lala Lajpat Rai was an avid reader. He was a voracious reader. He was very much into reading, friends. And he also read about the notion of patriotism and nationalism given by the Italian revolutionary, the famous named as Mazzini, Giuseppe Mazzini. Now, Mazzini was a big Italian leader, friends. Whatever he wrote, Lala Lajpat Rai read, and that had a big impact on his mind, friends. And actually, the thought process of Lala Lajpat Rai matched with some other members of the Indian National Congress, like with that of Bipin Chandra Pal, with Aurobindo Ghosh from Bengal, with Bal Gangadhar Tilak of Maharashtra. Now, they will form the extremist faction of the Indian National Congress in times to come. And especially this extremist caption will come to the forefront when this partition of Bengal will take place in 905. And then that will lead to Surat split of 1906. All of these things I have covered in my previous videos, friends. If I will remember, I will give the link in the description box below. Or you can search it and watch those videos on my channel, friends. Okay. So see, negative aspect of moderate policy, that is, these leaders, this Lal Bal Pal and Aurobindo Ghosh, they believed that these initial leaders of Indian National Congress, they are doing moderate politics. Now, this moderate politics is not going to give us anything. They were very much clear of this view. Okay, at that point of time, what was the strategy of Indian National Congress? That slowly, slowly, we will ask for gradual reforms, and slowly, slowly, through these gradual reforms, we'll ultimately achieve the dominion status. But at the start of the 20th century, this trio of Lal Bal Pal and Aurobindo Ghosh, they were combinedly saying that we should not go for dominion status. We should go for Purna Swaraj. Why dominion status? This is our country. Why a foreign rule is coming here and ruling us? We should ask not for dominion status, but Purna Swaraj. So actually, they were very much contradicting the moderate faction of the Indian National Congress. But the problem was that the moderate faction of the Indian National Congress was very dominant at that point of time. No matter, we should move forward and see. Also, Lala Lajpat Rai also believed in Hindu-Muslim unity. He thought that if Hindus and Muslims are united, India will be very strong. But many a times he said that it is very difficult to keep these two different communities united for a very long amount of time. So this he said in 1923 through an article published in the Tribune newspaper, which created a lot of controversy at that point of time. I will not go into it. That is a totally different thing. Then we will talk about the political career, friends. After this Surat split occurred and the moderates became again the dominating party in the Indian National Congress, and actually the role of extremist for the time being finished in Indian National Congress. Then after some time, friends, you know, Lala Lajpat Rai started putting his efforts in some other fields. Now the problem is that Lala Lajpat Rai thought that if the problems of India have to be solved, it cannot be solved from within. There has to be some outside support. And he thought that outer world should know that what this British rule is doing to India. So for that, he took a tour. He went to Britain in 1914 to appeal in the front of British people that what this British rule is doing to India. Then he went to United States of America in 1917, friends. And in the October month of 1917, he founded the Indian Home Rule League of America in New York. He stayed in America from 1917 to 1920. When Lala Lajpat Rai came back to India in 1920, friends, he was invited to preside over, you know, a very special session of the Indian National Congress. It happened in Kolkata. And after that, he was involved in many activities. See, nationalist activities gained momentum from that time. In 1915-16, Gandhiji came back to India. Okay, now Gandhiji was leading movements. Jallianwala Bagh tragedy occurred in Punjab. And after Jallianwala Bagh tragedy, Lala Lajpat Rai led peaceful demonstrations all over Punjab against this Jallianwala Bagh tragedy, friends. Also, when Gandhiji launched this non-cooperation movement in 1920, the command of taking forward this non-cooperation movement in Punjab was taken over by Lala Lajpat Rai. But due to the unfortunate incident of Chori Chora, Gandhiji took back the non-cooperation movement. Now, this thing was repudiated and rejected by Lala Lajpat Rai. Lala Lajpat Rai openly criticized Gandhiji, said that Gandhiji has made a mistake by withdrawing the movement for one incident of violence. So, all these things were happening, friends. And the finally, what happened that, the Montagu Chelmsford reforms of 1919, also known as Government of India Act of 1919. So there was a provision in this act that after 10 years, a commission would be formed to review the working of the act. And this commission was formed 2 years or 3 years in advance. So in 1927, this Simon Commission was formed. But the problem of the Simon Commission was that it had no Indian representation. There were absolutely no Indian member in the Simon Commission. All the white people were there in the Indian Simon Commission to decide the constitutional reform of India. This was not liked by Indians. And all over India, there were demonstrations against Simon Commission. One of that demonstration was being led in Lahore by Lal Lajpat Rai on 30th of October 1928. And this was responded to by the superintendent of police, James A. Scott, by a lathi charge. He authorized a lathi charge against the protesters, despite the fact that these protesters were doing non-violent protest. And this lathi charge specifically targeted Lala Lajpat Rai because he was the leader there. He was the main personality there. He was the crowd puller there. And obviously, friends, see, this is the act of 1928. Lala Lajpat Rai, born in 1865, he was 35 plus 28, around 63 years old at this point of time. Now, if you are going to hit a 63-year-old man on his chest with lathis, obviously, this thing is very difficult. Even a 20-year, 25-year-old boy cannot take, lathis on his chest, friends. So, obviously, he was too much injured in this lathi charge. And he remained bedridden for some amount of time. And finally, on 17th of November 1928, he breathed his last. And when he died, this thing was very much shocking for many people, especially the members of the Hindustan Socialist Republican Association. One thing I would like to tell you, friends, that I have made videos on Hindustan Republican Association and Hindustan Socialist Republican Association. If I will remember, I will give the link. Otherwise, you can search also. I have made videos on Yugantar Ashram also. All of those are already uploaded on my channel. So if you want to know about these organizations, their activities, what they did, for example, the Kakuri train accident, everything is uploaded on my channel. You can go and watch it. So, the members of the Hindustan Socialist Republican Association, Bhagat Singh, Chandrashekhar Azad, they mourned the death of Lala Lajpat Rai and they, vowed to avenge the death of Lala Lajpat Rai. They planned the assassination of Superintendent of Police Scott, but by mistake, they killed J.P. Saunders. Okay. Now, after that, friends, the role of Lala Lajpat Rai has been big. He has been an inspiration for a lot of people. He has been a firebrand of patriotism, nationalism among the people of India. He inspired young men of his people all over the country and especially in the region of Punjab. And people like Chandrashekhar, Azad and Bhagat Singh were very, very inspired by Lala Lajpat Rai, friends. Also, in addition to the political and Indian freedom struggle, friends, there are a lot of other fields where Lal Lajpat Rai has a huge contribution, friends. He had done in the field of, he had taken steps in the field of education, healthcare, commerce, friend. He was a big follower of Dayanand Saraswati and he was a very active member of Arya Samaj. He also helped to establish Dayanand Anglo-Vedic School. Also, friends, he initiated a bank. And this bank later came to be known as the Punjab National Bank, friends. Also, he established many, ventures in the field of healthcare, friends. He opened a hospital in the name of his mother, Gulab Devi, in 1927. This was known as the Gulab Devi Chest Hospital. It was basically a tuberculosis hospital for women. So this was slight information, brief information about Lala Lajpat Rai, friends. We are indebted to him for his service, selfless service to the nation. He was a great patriot, friends. Unfortunately, he didn't die a natural death. He died in an unfortunate mishap, okay, because of that lathi charge. And that was very much avenged by the young blood of India. And that was being tried as the Lahore conspiracy case in which Bhagat Singh, Rajguru and Sukhdev were hanged. This I have already covered in my previous videos also, friends. So thank you for watching these videos. I hope this video was helpful for you. As far as possible, I will try to give the link of the previous videos. Please like this video, friends. Subscribe this video. If you don't like, kindly tell me why you are not liking it and refer these videos more and more with your friends. Share it, friends. Goodbye. Take care.